After hearing about it for so long, Wyze has finally updated their application to support multicam view and a few other things. I'm Wanderer 001. Let's get into it. The primary focus of Wyze moving forward is their multicam solution. Here you can see the several Wyze cams that I have going. Video doorbell 2, backyard camera, which is a version 3, side camera is a version 3, I want to say, and this is an older version 2. And then same with the garage is also a version 2. You could see each of them has a live indicating that it's live. You could see a little timer there. We also, in the corner of each of them, have the ability to turn a camera on or off right from here in the quick view, and then give it a moment and it will reconnect, reestablish with that camera and load up the feed as soon as it makes that connection. Won't make you sit through that. You can also see for this particular camera, since this is the doorbell camera, there's no way to turn it off, and it does indicate that that has my Wyze Cam Plus subscription. The rest of them do not have the Cam Plus subscription. To get the most out of multicam, they do recommend the Cam Plus subscription with some of the things that they're doing. This was all on the homepage. The homepage has changed slightly in that now the homepage has some tabs at the top. Right now, this is the favorites page. If for whatever reason you want to move one of your favorites around, simply press and hold on your camera and drag it to your location. And that is just how simple it is to reorder your cameras. If we come over to the tab to the right, that is our devices tab. This is going to list out every Wyze product that you have. And notice that you have stars. A star would indicate a favorite, which would have it show up on that other tab. So in this case, if I come through my favorites, you could see they're all just cameras. But if I come right here and I do bedroom light, well, now when I come over to my favorites, bedroom light is right up there at the top. And again, just like anything else, click and drag it wherever you want it to be. If I want this at the bottom of the list, I can simply do that thusly, but I can untag that as well. And if we want to move any of these around, you know, I got a lot of things that are off, maybe light strip, I want you down here all the way at the bottom, we can do that. You can just press and hold and move things around on this page as well. They have redone their automations page, which used to be routines. Took me a moment there to remember that. But here we could see my automations. If I select this, it's gonna give you, in my case, all the automations that I had set up. Notice there's a lot of failures in here because primarily these were set up for motion triggers with a old Wyze sensor to turn on and off lights. And one of the sensors is not working, and that's why there's a bunch of false triggers in there. However, you can see they have a section kind of pre-established for you for scheduling. Here we have coming up in 7 hours. You have 10 a.m. to 6 a.m. every day. If I select this, it's going to show me this is enable it. Do I want to change the name of it? Which I could do. I could simply press that plus sign and give it a name. I'm going to cancel out of that. Add an action. Notice there are no devices. If I come in here, I can say Wyze Video Doorbell 2. What do I want to happen? Restart, turn on, turn off, turn on notifications, turn off notifications, quick reply, which is just for the doorbell, and then turn on motion warning and turn off motion warning. Notice those have the little shield icon. That means that there's that Wyze subscription level that you would need. We also have the ability to, maybe I don't want a camera, maybe I just want to say turn off notifications, and right there it'll add that to turn off notifications. And you could set a start time, an end time, and then what days of the week. We can also delete that automation, and I'll back out of there and not save any of the changes that I made. Notice they have a couple of preset ones for you so that you can play with them if you want. Coming down, we also have device and service triggers. Well, here I've got Christmas on, Christmas off, basement off. Okay, so these might be ones that I played with originally, so they might not pre-populate for you. My apologies. But if I come in here and I tap on that, it kind of shows me this particular routine. If Christmas tree, in this case, turns on, it would also turn on my Christmas light plug and my outdoor lights and not have a timer set for that. So those are devices. You can set those up as well. And I'll show you one more in a moment. We're gonna come down to the essential automations. These definitely play more in with the higher service level for Wyze, but if I select on vacation, well, here it's gonna list out all my light bulbs and plugs. I can add an action, which would be add something. So I could add the garage and I could say, turn this camera on and save, and that will kind of add it to this. But if I need to edit any of these, I simply come in here and tell it what to do. So turn on vacation mode, and depending on the device is what it would do. I have I'm away, I'm home, snooze my camera. So if I come in here, it's only listing the OG and it'll snooze that for 5 minutes, but I can add my backyard. And then here you can see on this different version, I can turn the sound siren on or off, notifications, but notice I cannot snooze this particular one. So depending on the cameras that you have, that's the Wyze Cam OG, even the Wyze Cam V3 isn't showing up in the list. So depending on the automation that you're trying to run, you might not be able to do it. But if you want to add an automation, again, formerly routines, come up to the plus sign in the upper right hand corner of the screen, and then come to automations. And then here it will allow you to kind of select what you want to do. And it gives you some prompts. Do you want to do a shortcut? Do you want to schedule something? Do you want to do device and or trigger? And then location trigger, again, based on all those things that we saw on the front of the page. So maybe I want to do a device trigger. So optional, you can give a name, hit that plus sign. So if set device as trigger, in my case, I'll say video doorbell 2. Well, what happens? Detects motion, is pressed, detects a pet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do pressed, and then the action to be taken is I'm going to find my basement lights here. So I'll say basement light 1, we're going to turn that on and save. And then I can do that with each of them so that when my doorbell is pressed, I will know that somebody's there because it turned on my lights if I was in the basement because I didn't hear it. And then I can select a time, start time and end time. That's when this particular trigger would run. And again, they kind of give you that information up front to do on your own. So you have, I am away. What are we going to do with all of these things? You would add to these preset ones right here because they're already pre-populated with pretty much everything that could be pre-populated with them. So that is all the new stuff on the home tab. Coming over to the events tab, this tab hasn't actually changed all that much since recent updates that they've had. You kind of have all your triggers. You can filter for a person, motion, select your camera. Then we have our little time thing that happens, and I'm gonna pause that really quickly for the slideshow to keep my wife out of that. She doesn't want to appear on video, so we'll just stop that. But this little timeline has also been moved down here to monitoring. This is, again, a place that you used to have to pay for to get access to some of this. Now you have access to it right here, and then it's having trouble loading that garage that I paused before. So we're gonna leave that as is for the time being. But right now we have disarm, home, and away. These actually require the Cam Unlimited subscription. Without the unlimited subscription, you can't do quick toggles up there, but you do get a 4-camera feed. You can see that this is a live feed, and then there's motion triggers for each of the areas. So in my case, I don't have a lot of action happening, but I have green lines letting me know that those were events. If I scroll this way, and you can see it, it changes the camera's feeds based on the event timeline. But if I come here, well, that's a person triggered event, and then these don't have any events at this particular timeline. If I were to select the events trigger so that I can show you, it has 2 events, and it will, this one has 2 events. There's 10 events up here, but this will allow it to cycle through all the events that are shown in a kind of time-lapse view. If I select events here, notice it's not going to bring me right to those events. It's only for these smart motion events. And then we have our daily slideshow, which again, we're gonna move that out of the way. And then for any one of these other ones, I can select to load it. And this one will be a little different. This one's just gonna be motion, but it gives you an idea of what it could be capturing. And those are the big changes that have been made to the Wyze app as of filming in 2024, mostly the home and mostly the monitoring. If you wanted to step up your account to a higher paid version, you'd get more access to things in the monitoring area as well as the home for the live feeds. But I'm giving you an example of what the application can do for you if you only have one camera that has Cam Plus and the rest are kind of just doing local. With these updates, it does bring the Wyze application on par with a few of the other competitors out there, although some of their features are still free, while Wyze, you do have to pay for them. Just food for thought and some data points for you to consider. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit that like button to help other viewers find it as well. If you like what I'm doing here and want to be notified of my next review, hit that subscribe button. Not sure if Wyze is the right camera company for you? On screen now, you'll see 2 other Wyze Cam videos that I've done to help you make a more informed decision for yourself.